Welcome to Delta 12, my name is Michael, and in this video I'm going to show you how to create a simple minimap for your game.
To create a simple minimap, we will use a PNG format file with the map design. So, we will use color hex to hide the parts of the map the player hasn't visited yet. And we will use color rect with animations to show which map the player is on.
Okay, let's start by creating a new scene. Let's add a color rect. So let's adjust the size to cover the entire screen area. Let's change the color to black, and in alpha let's leave it at 100. The alpha channel represented by the letter A works with color transparency. So the lower the alpha value, the more transparent the color will be. Okay, now we can rename the color rect to minimap. And then opening the world folder in files, let's drag the map.png file. Now let's create a node 2D and rename it to level 1. Let's add a color rect and call it hide. Let's then click on hide and drag to the position that represents level 1. Oh, a tip to ensure that only the selected node will be moved is holding the Alt key while clicking and dragging. Now we can adjust the size to cover the entire area. And then let's make it the same color as the background, clicking on the color picker and clicking on the desired color. Now let's duplicate hide using the shortcut Ctrl D and let's rename it to blink. Let's change the color to green. And then let's add an animation player. Now we need to create a blink animation. And in visibility properties, let's click on self-modulate. Leave the alpha channel at 0 and create a key. Let's click in 0.5 seconds and add a new key with alpha at 255. So we need to put this animation in loop and let's also enable autoplay. Well, that is the effect we will have to represent where the player is on the map. Okay, now we need to bring up the blink node so that it appears under the hide node. Now we need to repeat the same process for all other areas. Let's duplicate level 1, click on hide, drag it to the position of level 2. And so to adjust the size easier, let's make it a little transparent, and after we can back it to the normal color. Okay, let's hide. Sorry It looks like I'm speak German. Hide, hide. Maybe it means potato in German. If you speak German, tell us in the comments what does hide, hide means. Okay, let's go back to the word. Well, you know, we need hide, hide. So let's drag blink. And if you click on animation player, you can choose a frame in the animation where the color will be more transparent. Just don't forget to switch the animation back to the frame zero when you're done. Okay, let's show hide again, and then let's repeat the process. Okay, I will speed up the video in this part. Okay, now we just need to make the central level part. So let's duplicate the level 4, rename to central, adjust blink size, and then when adjusting the size of the hide, it is important that it's covered the entire area of the entrance as well. Okay, we already finished this part, so come on, hide, hide again. So we can create the labels that will show the level name and its position. Let's create the label level and adjust the text. And then we can duplicate it and create the label position. We can now create a script and save the scene. Well guys, this channel has grown a lot in the last few weeks thanks to your support. So I want to thank each one of you for every comment, every feedback, every like and sharing. You have been encouraging me to produce better and better content with each new video, so really thanks. I know at times this may seem like a very simple gesture, but it makes a big difference. Now let's open levels.gd. Let's create a map variable that will preload the minimap scene. Now let's add an input event function and let's order that. If the main scene doesn't already have a child node called minimap, then it should instantiate the preloaded scene minimap. And finally, let's pause the game while the scene is open. Okay, so we can back to the minimap script. And let's add the same input event function, which in this case will take the game out of pause and will close the minimap scene. So what will happen is that whenever the UI map key is pressed, if there is no scene called minimap, it will be instantiated and displayed. And if there is already the minimap scene and the key is pressed, the minimap will be closed. Okay, now we need to click on the project menu, project settings, input map, and then let's create the UI map action. And add the M key to execute this action. Okay, let's save. And we can already test. Fine, let's press the M key. And our minimap appears. Let's press again. And it's not working. Bem, o código parece que está certo, então eu devo ter esquecido alguma coisa. Okay guys, sorry, I forgot to put pause mode on process. Basically, any scene you want to still work when pause mode is on needs to be in process mode. Now we can test again. And okay, now it's working. Don't worry about this mess in the map, okay? Okay, now for the map title animation, keep running even during pause mode. Let's open the level name scene and change its pause mode to process 2. So we can save and close. Okay, now let's open the global.gd script and declare a new variable, which we will call visited and add an empty array to it. This variable will be responsible for saving the name of the levels that the player has already discovered in the game. Let's save and we can go back to minimap. Okay, now let's declare a local variable, which will also be called visited, and let's determine that its value will be the same as it is in the global visited variable. So let's create the hide map function, and let's declare that. If that is the name level 1 inside the variable visited, the height of the level 1 will be hidden, allowing the level 1 to be shown on the minimap. And then the same thing should be done for all other levels. Let's now create the blink function, in order that if the parent node is called level 1, the label level text will be level 1, the label position text will be left, and then blink will become visible. And you know, just repeat the same process for the other levels. Okay, now let's create the ready function to run the hide map and blink functions when the scene is loaded. Okay, now we need to turn all blink nodes invisible and make all hide nodes visible. And finally, let's open levels.gd and declare a visred variable, which will have the same value as the global visred variable, and a current level name variable. And then in where_if function, let's order that the current level name variable will save the name of the scene in which the script is loaded, which in this case are our levels, you know, as level 1, 2, central, etc. And then if there is no such name inside the visred variable, that is, if it is the first time the player enters this part of the map, the append current level name command will add the name to the list. And that is how the minimap script will know which levels have already been visited. Finally, you remember this code that instantiates the level name scene, right? I think showing the map name once is enough, so if you leave the code indentation that way, the name will only be shown on new maps. And if you indent to the left, the name will be shown on all maps, regardless of whether the player has already visited or not. Alright, now everything is ready, so let's test. Okay, level 1 left. You can see that center shows all entrances. Level 2 top. As you can see, the title animation keeps running even if the game is in pause mode. Well, guys, I hope you liked this tutorial. See you in the next video, and hide, hide.